Hey there, YouTube. Old Vegan Santa coming to you today with a little holiday cheer and a couple of Christmas tales. Hope everybody is having a lovely holiday season so far out there. And might want to say, if you're one of those real serious or uptight people, you might want to skip this one. This is a little, like I say, it's an alternative thought on Christmas, a little bit of a different way of thinking about some of the traditions around Santa Claus and all those kind of things. So just sit back and enjoy it. Don't take life too seriously, because God knows old Santa doesn't. Anyhow, let me read this, and then I got a long ride to make. I'm actually a little bit behind already. All right. And I'll tell you what I'm going to try to remember and do, because this is pretty cool stuff. I will drop a couple of links to some videos down below. I won't tell you what I'm dropping them to, because I want to let you ease into the article. But I'll drop a couple of links below on YouTube that are really fun that I looked at. So, Santa and Magic Mushrooms, the Shamanic Origins of Christmas Traditions. And this is from Medium, actually. It's written for there. I think there's some scientists in here at some point. One could trace the origin of Santa Claus and Christmas tradition to several theories, the most famous one being the story of Saint Nicholas, a 4th century Greek saint known for his generosity. Another theory links Santa's red and white color scheme to a genius Coca-Cola advertising campaign, yet elements of Santa Claus' tale and life, especially from the very popular "'Twas the Night Before Christmas" poem recited every year by millions around the world, reveal a different story. When one thinks of Christmas in this time of year, one immediately imagines the colors red and white, from the gift wraps to Christmas sweatshirts and, of course, Santa Claus' famous red and white attire. Ho, ho, ho. A red and white scheme is clear in the context of this holiday and the traditions surrounding it. Santa Claus' archetypal image can be dated to hundreds, if not thousands, of years, even found in the most unpredictable places and times. Since pre-Christian times, this time of year has always been a time of festivities and celebration, with music, dancing, banquets, and gatherings. Germanic peoples, for example, had the midwinter festival, Yule, which occurred around the winter solstice, 21st December. Also, the Romans had the festival of Saturnalia, an ancient festival in honor of the god Saturn, held on the 17th of December through to the 23rd of December. In the case of this article, we'll be dealing with the Siberian and Arctic regions, where shamans dropped into local homes with a bag full of magic mushrooms as presents in late December. Santa is a modern counterpart of a shaman, who consumed mind-altering plants and fungi to commune with the spirit world, he says. As the story goes, up until a few hundred years ago, these practicing shamans or priests connected to the older traditions would collect Amanita muscaria, the holy mushroom. If you want to look that up, I'll spell it out. That's Amanita, A-M-A-N-I-T-A, muscaria, M-U-S-C-A-R-I-A. Dry them and give them as gifts on the winter solstice, according to John Rush, an anthropologist and instructor at Sierra College. Amanita muscaria is found throughout the northern hemisphere under conifers and birch trees, just like presents found under the Christmas tree by excited, happy children. This explains the tradition of the Christmas tree and the gifts wrapped in red and white, placed under the tree just like the magic mushrooms. Amanita muscaria is classified as poisonous. This might be a reason the shamans of that time initially hung the fresh Amanita muscaria to dry on tree branches, just like the colorful ornaments on a Christmas tree. And so you'll get a look and you'll kind of know what we're talking about there. That's the Amanita muscaria. Santa's flying reindeer have a similar connection to the Amanita muscaria mushrooms. Reindeer in general are common across Europe and Siberia, and just like the human inhabitants of these areas, they too consumed mushrooms. Harvard University biologist Donald Pfister suggests that Siberians who ingested the mushrooms may have hallucinated that the grazing reindeer were actually flying. Research has shown that reindeer do in fact have a fondness for the Amanita muscaria. Deputy editor of the pharmaceutical journal, Andrew Haynes, wrote in 2010 that animals deliberately seek out the red and white spotted mushrooms in their habitats, as they have a desire to experience altered states of consciousness. Haynes also wrote, for humans, a common side effect of mushrooms is the feeling of flying. So it's interesting, the legend about Santa's reindeer is they can fly. According to The Sun, Haynes even claimed that reindeer seek out the mushrooms to escape the monotony of long, dreary winters. Smart reindeer. At first glance, one thinks it's ridiculous, but it's not, said Carl Ruck, a professor of classics at Boston University. Whoever heard of reindeer flying? I think it's becoming general knowledge that Santa is taking a trip with his reindeer. To add to things, Rudolph's red nose might have a representation of the Amanita muscaria, while the idea of helper elves assisting Santa in making children happy might go back to the spirits encountered by the shaman during a mushroom trip. One historian, Ronald Hutton, told NPR that the theory of a mushroom-Santa connection is flawed. Boo. If you look at the evidence of Siberian shamanism, which I've done, Hutton said, you find that shamans didn't travel by sleigh, didn't usually deal with reindeer spirits, very rarely took the mushrooms to get trances, didn't have red and white clothes. Yet Rush and Ruck disagree. According to the two researchers, the shamans did actually deal with reindeer spirits, and the ingestion of mushrooms is well documented. Siberian shamans did wear red deer pelts, but the coloring of Santa's garb is mainly meant to mirror the coloring of Amanita mushrooms, Rush added. As for sleighs, the point is not the mode of travel, but that the trips in air quotes, involving the transportation to a different celestial realm, Rush said. Sometimes people would also drink the urine of the shaman or the reindeer, as the hallucinogenic compounds are excreted this way, without some of the harmful chemicals present in the mushrooms, which are broken down by the shaman or the reindeer, according to Rush. People who know about shamanism accept this story, Ruck said. Is there any reason that Santa lives in the North Pole? Is it a tradition that can be traced back to Siberia? In conclusion, all theories of the origin of Christmas traditions could have some elements of truth. And with that said, this excerpt from James Arthur's Mushrooms and Mankind, the impact of mushrooms on human consciousness and religion, probably best summarizes the Santa magic mushroom theory. So, why do people bring pine trees into their houses at the winter solstice, placing brightly colored red and white packages under their boughs as gifts to show their love for each other and as representations of the love of God and the gift of His Son's life? It is because underneath the pine bough is the exact location where one would find this most sacred substance, the Amanita, in the wild. That's a good one. Another one that it kind of covers a lot of the same stuff, but I'll see if there's some different things in here. 8 Ways Magic Mushrooms Explain the Santa Story. Some of them are the same. I see John Rush's name, the archaeologist, or the archaeologist, anthropologist. Number one, Arctic shamans gave out mushrooms on the winter solstice. According to the theory, blah, 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 about the same thing. Number two, mushroom. It's just kind of a summary of what I said before, so I'll just read them. I'll just read the headline. Mushrooms, like gifts, are found beneath pine trees. Reindeer were shaman spirit animals. Shamans dressed like Santa Claus. Let me see. I think I had a photo over here of one of the old shamans dressed as Santa Claus. Kind of cool. Yep, shamans dressed like Santa Claus. Mushrooms abound in Christmas iconography. Tree ornaments shaped like Amanita mushrooms and other depictions of the fungi. Rudolph's nose. A visit from St. Nicholas may have borrowed from shaman rituals. And Santa is from the Arctic. I heard about this one. I can't remember exactly when it was. I think it was back at the early part of this year. I was listening to, think I was listening to an old episode of the Joe Rogan Experience, and I forgot who he was talking to. I've heard some of this stuff. I like to listen to Terrence McKenna on subjects dealing with psychedelics like that. But I find stories like that where you see different traditions blending and explanations kind of fascinating. So ever since I got a hold of that one, I've Googled it from time to time, and I go to YouTube. Like I say, I'll try to drop a couple of videos I like down in the description below. But if I forget, just go to YouTube and type Santa Claus mushroom, and you'll get some cool stuff that comes up. But anyhow, just a little fun, just a little something to do on a Christmas Eve. Hope you all are happy and healthy out there. It's been a tough year, but hey, we're still here. We're still alive. We're still breathing. And been a tough year for me too, but I'm just making the best out of it. I wish all of you happiness, health, love, and nothing but good things in 2021. So Merry Christmas and peace out from your tripping vegan Santa.